I copied and pasted the next view because they had a little bit of a drawing, so I thought better than me drawing it myself. So on problem number 13, it says, and I cut it off a little bit, what is the volume of the figure below? Well, the volume is just the width times the height times the depth. So the volume is just going to be, we could say volume is going to be, the width is x plus 4 times x plus 1 times x plus 6, right? X plus 4 times x plus 1, we can do this in our head, but I always, well, let's just, well, I always find it easier to do it this way. X plus 4 times x plus 1. 1 times 4 is 4. 1 times x is x. And then you have the x place. X times 4 is 4x. X times x is x squared. Fair enough. So that equals x squared plus 5x plus 4. And now we have to multiply that times x plus 6, right? We did x plus 4 and x plus 1, and this was a 6. X plus 6, that's this side. So now we multiply this times x plus 6. 6 times 4 is 24. 6 times 5x is 30x. 6 times x squared is 6x squared. Hope you can read what I'm writing. Scroll down a little bit. Now we do the x's place. I'll do it in a different color because I think I'm going to run out of. So x times 4 is 4x. X times 5x is 5x squared. 5x squared. X times x squared is x to the third, to run into the white area. So this is x to the third, what's 6 plus 5? Plus 11x squared plus 30x. No, no, sorry, 30 plus 4 plus 34x plus 24. So x to the third, all of these choices are x to the third, plus 11x squared, so it's either b or d, plus 34x, that's that one, plus 34x plus 24. So the choice is b. Next problem. Next problem. All right. 8a to the third plus c to the third, which of these choices? So that's interesting. This is not a trivial thing to just factor. You know, you just have to, we'll have to do some intuition here. Let's think about it. In order to have a positive number for the a term, every time we're multiplying it, well, every time we're multiplying, we have to have positive. So this is 2a times 2a times 2a. That would get us to 8a to the third. But there's something interesting about choice A, why I already feel like canceling out choice A. Choice A is essentially 2a plus c to the third power, right? Choice A is 2a plus c to the third power. And every time you multiply this out, every time you multiply 2a plus c times itself, you're going to add more terms. No terms are going to cancel out. I mean, if you were to square this, you're going to get, you know, just to show you, you get 4a squared plus 4ac plus c squared. And then to get the third power, you'd multiply that times 2a plus c. So you're going to get this thing with, you're actually going to get four terms. So this is, 2a, choice A is definitely not the case. In order for one of these to simplify to this, we're going to have some positives and negatives there that cancel out terms as you expand these polynomials. So let's look at the other choices, see if they make any sense. 2a times, and I like looking at the a terms and the what generates the c cubed terms, and maybe we can cancel out some things. 2a times 4a squared, yeah, that's 8a to the third. But minus c times c squared, that's minus c to the third. Right? So when I don't even have to worry about multiplying this whole thing out. I know because the c cubed term is going to come only from this term multiplied by this term. Right? And there'll be other terms that hopefully will cancel out. But we know that choice B cannot be the choice, because minus c times c squared is minus c to the third. And this is a plus right here. So we know B can't be the right answer. Let's see. Choice C. I can use the same logic. We have a minus c and we have a plus c. And we have a plus c here. We would have to have two plus c's in order for this to work, so this can't be the answer. So just by deductive reasoning, I can say it's probably choice D, but I'm going to prove it to you since we're here to learn, not to just answer things correctly. So if I were to multiply those two numbers, I have 4a squared minus 2ac plus c squared, and I'm multiplying that times 2a plus c. 2a plus c. So I'm going to mix up all of the terms a little bit, but you will get the idea. So the important thing when you're multiplying, you could do this in your head, is that you multiply each of these terms times each of those. So c times all of that plus this times all of that. So c times all of that is c times c squared. And I'm not doing it the right place notation like I did last time because it gets a little more confusing now. But c times c squared is c to the third. C to the third. C times minus 2ac is minus 2ac squared, right? C times 4a squared is 4a squared c. And then, now we can do this one. 2a times c squared, that is the same thing as, I'm going to put it in this place because it turns into ac squared, right? Ac squared, and I have a 2. So 2a times c squared is 2ac squared. 2a times minus 2ac, that's, let's see, you get a minus 4a squared c. So it's minus 4a squared c. This is a plus here. And then 2a times 4a squared is 8a to the third. And luckily enough, let's see, they get 8a to the third. 8a to the third. This cancels out. This cancels out, and you get plus c to the third. So we were right by doing our deductive reasoning that choice D was the answer. Next problem. Let me have run out of space. Run out of space. And let me see what the next problem even is. OK. Actually, where was I? Oh, OK, I see. OK, problem 15. The total area of a rectangle is 4x to the fourth minus 9y squared. Which factors could represent the length times the width? OK, so essentially, you're saying the length times the width is going to be equal to the area, which is 4x to the fourth minus 9y squared. So to some degree, we have to factor this into multiple expressions. And the first thing you should always look at when you have to factor any type of an expression, especially if there's only two terms in the expression, does it fit the form a squared minus b squared? Because if it does, you can factor this into a plus b times a minus b. And if you don't trust that these equal each other, I've made multiple videos about it, but just multiply them. A plus b times a minus b is equal to a squared minus b squared. And luckily, this fits that format, right? If a, let's see, if a squared was equal to, a squared is equal to 4x to the fourth, then what's a? A would be equal to 2x squared, right? And if b squared is equal to 9y squared, then b is equal to the square root of that, which is 3y. Right? And so this definitely is equal to a squared minus b squared. So this expression right here can be factored into a plus b times a minus b. So a plus b is 2x squared plus 3y times a minus b, 2x squared minus 3y. Let's see, which choice is that? 2x squared plus 3y. OK, this switched the order. Choice A says 2x squared minus 3y times 2x squared plus 3y, which is the same thing. You can switch orders when you're multiplying. So the answer is A. Next problem, problem 16. I'll switch colors arbitrarily. Problem 16. Which product of factors is equivalent to? Let me copy and paste this, because this is an interesting. So let me copy and paste this problem. OK, I've copied it. And now let me paste it here. OK, which product of factors is equivalent to that thing over there? So let's simplify that. That's my first impulse. Oh, no. We don't even have to simplify it. We don't even have to simplify it. This fits our same pattern, right? If we can fit the pattern a squared minus b squared. So look at this thing. This has x plus 1 squared minus y squared. So if we said that a is equal to x plus 1 and b is equal to y, then we fit the pattern, right? This is a squared minus b squared. So then this thing can just factor into a plus b times a minus b. Let me write. So what's a plus b? It's x plus 1 plus y, right? That's a plus b. And then a minus b is x plus 1 minus y. And that is choice D. That problem was easier than I thought it was going to be. Choice D. Right there. Right there. All right. And I'm out of time again. I'll see you in the next video.